When you travel, it's so easy to fall into this roller coaster of exciting emotions and people and discovering new places. But sometimes you might find that you're losing track of what were those intentions you have set for your trip.
Hello everyone, I'm Silvia.
And I'm Michal.
And today we're going to be sharing with you some tips that we have been using for our journey as a digital nomad couple who travels the world together. But if you're traveling on your own, these tips might also be useful for you. So stick around and see what we have to say.
We've traveled quite a lot, both in a couple, but also individually. We explored different ways of traveling. We traveled fast when we've seen many countries in a very short amount of time. We traveled slow when we were a bit longer in one place. We hitchhiked, we took different ways of transportation. And all those experiences allowed us to find our travel style that we are applying now to our life and that we are most in tune with.
Currently, we really enjoy traveling slowly. It's more like we actually live in different places because we tend to stay in one place for a very long time. And as we travel, we also work together in our project. But sometimes traveling and having this lifestyle can prove to be more challenging than we expect. And there are some tips and some tricks that we have been finding very useful to make things easier and that we would like to share with you today.
First and foremost, we are focusing on our intention. So what is it that we want from this trip? And this can mean very different things. So for example, we're looking for stability and creative inspiration and freedom to build our business together. So we would be looking for a space where we can actually live in an environment where we can feel nurtured, where we will have time and space to record videos for you and brainstorm and have time to actually build our business. But also at the moment, our diet is based mostly on fruits. So we will look for a warm climate where fruit is accessible and abundant and we have easy access to it. Whatever it is that is your intention, keep it in mind.
Number two, we really enjoy traveling slowly. For us, stability is very important, so we usually try to stay in one place for at least 2 months. Maybe stability for you might mean staying 2 weeks in one place, but we find it very useful to have enough time so that we can settle in, enjoy the place, explore, be productive there, and then have enough time to prepare for our next destination.
Tip number three, stick with essentials. When I first moved abroad, I took 4 backpacks and a suitcase with me. Really, it was ridiculous. I still don't know what I was thinking. At the moment, I'm traveling with a small 40-liter backpack and it fits all my life. All the objects are there and I'm more than happy and I still feel that I can get rid of some of them. Pack only what is essential. If you find that you're missing something, you can always buy it in your destination. It's really not a problem and it will save you from carrying lots of useless things that in a year you'll use once or maybe not even once.
Traveling this way brings us a lot of mental clarity and this empty space that gives us so much relief to know that we can just move somewhere else tomorrow and everything is in our backpack.
And it's wonderful to be able to pack everything in less than 10 minutes.
Number four, we find it very useful to find time for ourselves, for each other, and to meet other people. It's important to connect with ourselves so that we can have emotional balance and that so that we can reflect on our lives and our goals and our progress. It's important for us to find this space to connect with each other and work on our relationship. And it's incredibly important to find time to meet new people because this is one of the most amazing things about traveling, is going out, meeting new cultures, making new friends. So finding the perfect balance between these three things is a crucial aspect to be aware of for us.
Tip number five, find balance between inspiration and stability. We found it very important to be able to fulfill both of those needs. And it's really the same if you're even in your hometown. Sometimes you need ideas and talks with inspiring people and party and social contacts and new insights. Sometimes you would rather stay at home and process everything that's been happening and nurture yourself and rest. We found that this is always very important to keep in mind.
Number six, budget. We find it so important to keep track of our expenses and our savings and our income. We do it together as we just like to share our finances, but you can do that individually. We just find that it brings us a lot of peace and clarity to know what we are spending, know what we are earning, and it really reduces our stress around the issue of money.
And that brings us to the last tip, which is reviewing your goals from time to time. When you travel, it's so easy to fall into this roller coaster of exciting emotions and people and discovering new places. But sometimes you might find that you're losing track of what were those intentions you have set for your trip. For us, we find it very useful to sometimes just sit down, relax, and think about what was it that we wanted from this trip? What is it that we want now? Maybe something changed. What can we improve? Those reviews help us to stay on track with our progress and make us happier and keep improving every day.
We actually have a lot more to say about this, but we wanted to keep this video short. So if you want to know something else about our journey and what we do to make our trip as a digital nomad couple the best possible, just let us know in the comments and we might record other videos in the future about this topic.
Thank you very much for watching. We hope you found this useful and we wish you fair winds and the most incredible journey.
So much love to you.